How dare you trespass here? How dare you trespass here? dare you trespass here? here. How dare you trespass here? How dare you trespass here? Yeah.
perfect sacrifice!
How dare you trespass here?
evil person? This is on me! There are more coming!
This place was the largest granary in Stoneguard, with a water source that spanned the entire dominion. But one day, the cursed rain fell, and the water source was tainted. The wizards of Venelux cut off the water supply with giant monoliths to prevent the contamination from spreading. The area quickly turned into the desert it is today.
Resistance. Everyone flocks
to claim
the room.
Was his heart broken again?
Contract coins, anyone is welcome. Take a look. What do you need? Take a look around.
See you later.
Yeah. Things continue. The desert may become contaminated.
Hey!
Hey! Are you an adventurer?
I am a venom.
Monoliths are rocks embedded in the desert.
But
maybe I need to.
Thank you.
All right, let's go. This. We're almost there.
A light! I fixed it!
All right, let's start again. There.
The magic flux.
A light! I fixed it! All right, let's start again. We're almost there.
The magic flux is...
A light! I fixed it!
I finished the investigation safely,
thanks to you. This is my gift for your help. Thank you.
need a guardian to go with him. I couldn't send him off alone there. Damn Ukarak. We need to return. Okay, please help me! Maybe over there. Let me see. Is it here? Let's go set off. Oh my, please help me!
Einar cherishes us all.
Yeah.
but the... So, if anyone reads this...
In the rocky terrain to the northwest of Stoneguard, there is a path formed by a giant sandworm passing through the rocks. We should be cautious, as there have been frequent reports of missing adventurers here recently.
Out of underground caves.
I'm not sure. Maybe there's something in the caves that the sand...
Warning, these...
Oh my, I'm done for. Oh, my cameras. Oh, I'm completely ruined because of Queen.
At first, I went around the pile consisted of bones. Everyone told me I should be happy. Queen Belandia, she ruined my life. You mean the sandworm lair?
Glenn Richhill wanted to dissuade his daughter from trying to hunt down Queen Belandia. He was well aware of the Queen's horror, given that he died after losing his leg to her. Having witnessed the arc.
Of making and selling sandworm bait.
Thank you. I got lucky. Queen, I am Josephine Kraft. I discovered that. Did you go looking for Queen? Oh, I understand.
I'm busy doing some maintenance at the moment, my friend. Were you hoping to go up to see the observatory? As you can see, the ladder is under repair. It will take some time to fix it properly. Maybe you can fly down to the observatory, if you can jump.
Seen you before, so what you're saying is that Queen Belandia is a monster that can't be beaten.
I don't know why a complete stranger. Everyone who's ever lived in this area, we're fighting so that this tragedy.
The investigation team stumbled across Queen Belandia during their survey, leading her to launch a fierce attack. If it had not been for the wizard Josephine Kraft, they might have failed to escape. You then sought out Marcia Richhill, Glenn's daughter and Sandworm Raid Group captain. You tried to persuade her to cease her plan to defeat Queen Belandia. However, she did not relent.
I must see a rich.
Thank you.
comes like. Why do you ask?
There you... Good heaven. What?
When Glenn realized that he couldn't stop his daughter, he decided to help her. He recalled the trap Marcia had prepared and thought that if he could lure Queen Belandia there, his daughter could achieve her goal without being in danger. Perhaps the wizard Josephine can find a way to help Marcia.
Again.
Ah, I see.
So, you... Oh, come to think, he also wrote with the potents. If that doesn't work, you'll have... It's true that Pal Queen Belandir's Powell, so you really didn't. If someone with evil... Let's try making a... You can easily find plenty of armadillos in the Moonlight Desert, but if you defeat them recklessly first, make sure they're stunned by the trap before you go to kill them. That way, sandworms make stronger poison when they are young. There is a resistance force that guards the sandworm hatchery near its lair.
Josephine recalled some passages in Clay's book, and found a way to lure Queen Belandia. She also informed you that the source of Queen Belandia's power was something known as a star fragment. Though star fragments contain pure power, someone created a monster called Queen Belandia out of evil intent. decided to use Queen Belandia's attraction to powerful mana to lure her in. Now, in order to create artificially powerful mana, you need to create a lure using Armadillo's sharp scales.
Wizards combating the dark magic built a barrier magic circle at the Sanctum of Desire, resulting in the sudden appearance of a waterfall. This resulted in the creation of a small pond with water pristine enough to drink. Naturally, it became a place of respite for desert merchants, as well as geographers and archaeologists during their expeditions.
Take a look around before you set off.
Contracts in this region. Contracts in this region.
Sandworms usually come out of underground caves.
This is a sandworm hatchery. It's a dangerous place, so if you're looking for poison sacks, then you'll need to find a baby sandworm. But they are very sensitive. Good. Maybe you could shapeshift yourself into an insect. Good. I'll brief you the details after we get in. Let's go. I'll know. Now, you can get what I need. You can get potent poison sacks from baby sandworms. Shapeshift into an insect and approach them. Shapeshift into an insect and approach them. get potent poison sacs from baby sandworms. Shapeshift into an insect and approach them. You can get
what I need is a sand.
Expect to discover this precious thing. The shell is very fragile. Try not to damage it. Chip. I shouldn't have come here. Let's get out of here before...
The potent sandworm poison sac is also used as a raw material for mana production. It is particularly suitable for a mana amplifier to lure Queen Melandia, because it can be used to freely adjust the emitted level of mana based on external conditions.
Thank you.
Here lies the impregnable fortress, guarded by giant ants. Even the magical forces of Archeum could not occupy this place. There is a legend that the very same power which made Stoneguard barren created a giant and cruel Queen Ant.
In time, I found the right magic schema that we can use for the bait. Since you have all the ingredients, first, put the potent sandworm poison sac over here. A plot failed. Hard to believe. Elemental fusion stones are riddled with impurities, making it difficult to use them for complex schema, like the magic schema for attracting monsters. Naturally, we just need to make a pure. I'll prepare everything else, so please get me the required materials. We're going to need some moonlit sand crystals. Sand crystals are available in the highlands around the sandworm lair. And
the first attempt to build the device for luring Queen Belandia ended in failure. Since common elemental fusion stones often contain impurities, they cannot be used to contain delicate and complex schema, like the magic schema for attracting monsters. Josephine explained that making a pure elemental fusion stone will make up for this error. Purified water used to draw a magic schema is essential to making a pure elemental fusion stone. This is because low water purity can lead to errors in the schema. In the desert where water is scarce, cactus water can be used as a viable substitute.
How dare you trespass here? How dare you trespass here?
is important to consider not only the size of the sand particles used for the pure elemental fusion stone, but also whether they can...
You there, do you need a contract?
Contracts in this region may be
dangerous. Welcome.
Thank you.
Farewell, and take care.
The Moonlight Oasis, located in the very center of the Moonlight Desert, was formed by the powerful archwizard Soren Warnak. In the past, the oasis drew in many tourists, but current visitors to the area are primarily interested in gathering moonlight scales from the nearby creatures.
If you want to know more about Queen Balandir, I'm sure Clay's book will help.
In the past, Salavian Order Grand Elf. The sandworm's poison sac, the source of poisonous mana, reacts sensitively to external. Not only can it adjust the level of mana emitted depending on these conditions, it also
You can get a glimpse of Clay's interest in the various monsters and poisons of Cilicium through his books. These books contain interesting information, such as the fact that the mighty Queen Balandia was originally a small sandworm, and that sandworm poison sacs have the rare ability to detect another being's mana.
Will increase to the maximum limit. Queen Balandir will sense the power now. Here's how to Like I mentioned, I made the device for luring Queen Balandir so it can be controlled. Queen Balandir will appear soon after pressing the button, so make sure you find yourself someplace safe before using it.
Having finished crafting the pure elemental fusion stone, the device for luring Queen Balandir was complete. After installing the device, you press the button of the remote control to amplify the mana emitted and attract Queen Balandir. The remote control must be operated at a minimum safe distance from the device.
What brings you here this time? We can lure Queen Belandia with that device? Really? If that's true, I can catch her right now.
Most members of the raid group are at the Sandworm Hatchery right now. If we want to catch Queen Belandia, we need them to return so we can attack together.
My troops are currently working to reduce the number of sandworms. They won't come back until they achieve their objective. If you get out there and help them with their mission, they'll be able to come back sooner. It's up to you. Everyone is bringing their very best to this mission. Everything we learn along the way is recorded in the operation plan back at camp. Read the operation plan at the Eastern Gathering campsite. I'm sure it'll help you too.
Upon learning about the luring device, Marcia wanted to catch Queen Belandia immediately. However, in order to do so, a full-scale offensive involving the entire Sandworm raid group is needed, and most of the troops are already active in the Sandworm hatchery. Marcia's troops need help to finish the job and return quickly.
What? Chosen one, you have come safely. If you want special powers, prove your worth. Walk all the way across the footholds. Not everything. with the sandstorm, I will test your limits. Final hurdle. Fight and win.
I am Ventilux, but after his arrogant Ventilux.
Well done. Now, I bet you, they tricked me into becoming a god.
You trespass here. trespass here. Trespass here.
Sandworm Raid Group regularly carries out operations to reduce the sandworm population. Once these begin, all but essential members of the squad remain in the sandworm hatchery and only return when the mission is complete. The best and only way to get the squad...
Adventurer! Want to make some money? The merchant unions buy moonlight scales from desert creatures for high prices. The Castle, Wave, and Crescent Blade merchants decided to participate. The purchase scales have 3 rounds of deliveries. The quantities and times have been set. Everyone has decided to pay 2 coins, twice the going rate, and even 3 if it's urgent. How about it? Don't you want to search for moonlight scales?
I've been waiting. Thanks to you, my troops returned earlier than expected. We've set so many traps for Queen Belandia already. But with the luring device you brought, we'll be able to attract... Okay, I marked the location on the map. You can go there, find the chest in the center, and install the device. We'll be preparing to attack her in the...
Marcia and her group had already set up a trap in the hopes of catching Queen Belandia. Unfortunately, it had proved useless, with the Queen never showing up at it. With the new luring device, however, she could be attracted to the trap and captured as planned.
You
The place Marcia mentioned was filled with bombs and gunpowder chests.
Adventurers, we're now accepting the first round of deliveries. You have 3 minutes. Also, Crescent Blade merchants will pay triple the market rate.
You're back. We're all set here. Shall we begin the up? If we press this button, Queen Belandia will show up. There she is.
Marcia pressed the button on the remote switch. Queen Belandia charged. Her fierce attack was cut short when she stopped in the middle of the trap and took flight.
After so many tries, I thank you. What do you mean? My father, really? I don't want to catch Queen Belandia just because every time I felt discouraged. My father, I'm going to rebuild our family home. So, if you see my father again, we will kill Queen Belandia soon. It is a monument, but
Marcia succeeded in critically injuring Queen Belandia and felt confident that the next battle against her would be the last. When she learned all of this stemmed from her ghostly father's request, she was filled with bittersweet gratitude. A stone engraved with the names of all those killed by Queen Belandia rests on one side of the camp. This memorial only honors the officially identified victims, so it is impossible to guess how many more fell prey to her over the years. Queen Belandia, the Invincible. The all-consuming. No one had ever even so much as scratched the fearsome beast. Enter the Order of the Swan, a small-time guild hired by the Resistance to help gather sandworm poison sacks. While the Resistance soldiers were mopping up the sandworms, they were suddenly dragged into the sand beneath their feet. One of the swans, Rowan, fell into the vortex. All at once, Queen Belandia reared up, writhing in pain. Rowan had morphed into a violet phoenix and burst free from Queen Belandia's carapace, freeing everyone trapped inside. To this day, the mere sight of a human touched with malvescence is enough to violently enrage the mighty beast. Humans only defeated Queen Belandia once in the past. Among those she devoured that day was Rowan.